It's Wednesday, Klaus here. It's time for another basic DaVinci Resolve tutorial.
It's Wednesday, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another basic DaVinci Resolve tutorial. In this episode, which is going to be the last episode this year, we are going to make some fireworks. And I'll show you some different ways we can make a shot look just like this. So again, I'll show you different ways of doing this shot. So first up, we're just going to start with this footage right here. It is a stock clip of San Francisco, and we're going to make some fireworks. So let's jump into Fusion. So here in Fusion, we have our media in and our media out. And we are just going to go up to the effects library. I'll go into templates, I'll go to Fusion, and I'll go down to particles. And in particles, we actually have a firework which are built for us, so we don't have to do anything, or at least not anything yet to this. So here I have a Fusion composition built by Blackmagic, so we can easily connect this to our media in, and it's going to get us a merge node. And that's basically what we need to do to make fireworks inside of DaVinci Resolve. Of course, we might have a little bit of a problem. As you see, our fireworks are covering up the city, and I want this to be behind. How can we fix that? There's actually a pretty simple solution to our problem. We're going to take our media in, right-click, and I'm simply just going to copy the media in, and I'm going to right-click again over here, and I'm going to paste it in. So now I have it here, and then I'm going to push 1 on my keyboard, so I have it over in the first viewer, and I'm just going to take in a polygon. And what I need to do is simply just to mask out the foreground here, or the buildings. So in normal circumstances, we would do a extremely detailed job, but to keep this tutorial a little bit shorter, we are just going to do a very, very rough mask of the skyline here. Like that. So it's important just to get the tallest buildings, I think, out of what I saw here. Okay, let's see. We can, of course, zoom in and do a very detailed job if we want to, but for the tutorial, we are not going to do that. Something like that. And, you know, I think if we just take this tall building here, we should be good enough and safe enough to this thing. So I'm just going to finish up my mask here. Something like that. So, and I'm going to take my mask and I'm just going to drag this into the merge one. So it will make another merge, and it's now going to put this in front. So as you see right now, if we go back, we are going to have our fireworks behind the buildings. Pretty fast, pretty easy indeed. However, let's pretend you don't want to do any masking whatsoever. We could do another thing as well. Again, I'll go into the effects library, effects, and I'm going to take a new Fusion composition. I'm just going to drag that down here, make it a little longer. I'm going to select that, and then I'll just go into Fusion with that selected. Okay, then I'm just going to take a background. I'm going to connect my background to my media out. I'll select the background and I'll go to the inspector, and in the alpha, I'm just going to drag this all the way down so we have a transparent background. Then I'll do the same thing by going into the templates, Fusion, particles, and fireworks. And then, you know, I'm just going to connect this down to the background. And here we have our fireworks again. Going back to the editing page, I'll take my fusion composition, put this on top of the clip I want to use. And now, of course, we have the same problem as before. It's the fireworks are now in front of our buildings. But a super easy way is, of course, to simply just take our fusion composition and zoom this down a little bit and then move it away from the building. So now we have this little effect here. Again, a super easy way of doing that effect as well. So we could move it up a little bit so it's out of the buildings. So that was the free way of doing this effect. If you are using a service like Storyblocks or something like that, you can get assets from there and it will work the same way. You can take that and put that on top. And now we have that effect. And again, we can move this around so we can take the fireworks someplace else. Move it out of the way here, something like that. Also, we can do the same thing if we, for instance, go back to our first thing here, and I'll go back to the fusion, and I'm just going to take off the fireworks and move that out of the way, and I'll go to my media pool, and I'm just going to take this thing here, and I could easily connect this to the merge. And if we play this again, you'll now see that the fireworks will still be behind the building because we're still using the mask we did for the first example. So that's three different ways of adding fireworks into your shot. Pretty fast and pretty easy, also free. And of course, if you have a subscription for Storyblocks, you can do it that way. So last thing to do is just to wish you a happy new year. I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.